notes. Where do they live? What do they eat? Where do they come from? Today, you're gonna finally understand, well, notes in Fusion.
So I've already got my timeline open and this B-roll waiting, and today I'm gonna show you the basics of nodes in Fusion by making a simple lower third, like this one. So first of all, making sure the playhead is over the B-roll, we're gonna head over straight to Fusion. And this is the final node graph we're gonna be doing today. Don't get intimidated by it, it's actually very easy to do, and I'm gonna guide you step by step. So let's start by removing this, let's put it aside for now, and let's focus on nodes. So first of all, what are nodes? Well, they are basically these little boxes right here that allow you to create complex visual effects and motion graphics. Each of these little boxes contain a specific action or effect that tells Fusion what to do. So for example, this is my media 1, or my B-roll, and this is my media out, where everything we do in between here will be sent back to our timeline. So unlike traditional layer-based systems such as After Effects, nodes provide you a lot more flexible and modular approach to creating and manipulating images. So for example, if I want to manipulate my image, I can add a transform node, and I can do that a couple ways. I can click anywhere in the node graph, then hit shift spacebar on the keyboard, and look for XF, and then click add, and it's gonna appear in my node graph. And right now, this node doesn't do anything, but I can connect it to my media one and start working with it. So normally a node has three connection points, this yellow one, which is the input, this blue one, which is the mask input, and this one, which is the output. So to connect my transform node with my media one, I can simply click and hold my transform node, drag it over this line right here, and then holding shift, when this line gets blue, I can drop it. And now it's connected, see? Now here in the inspector, I can start manipulating my image. So I can increase or decrease the size, change the aspect, the angle, and flip it horizontally or vertically. And there are many, many, many types of nodes that perform a ton of different tasks. For example, I can delete my transform node, and I can add a blur node. Now I can increase the blur size, and my image will get blurry. See? Another thing I can do with nodes is use masks. And masks are basically nodes that limit the area where our effect happens. If I drag this rectangle mask and connect it to this blue input of the blur, I can increase the blur, and the mask will limit the area where the blur affects my image. See? I can also use an ellipse mask and blur this Apple logo, like this. And I can use the polygon mask, which allows me to create any shape I want for the mask, like this. I can even stack multiple masks together. Like, I can add a mask to blur out my Apple logo, and I can hit Command C or Control C, and then Command V or Control V, and drag another mask to blur out this TV, see? And I can soften the edge of my mask to make it look more natural. What I can also do is merge nodes together. If I want to place a text in my image, I can grab this text node and connect the output of my text node to the output of my media one, and a merge node will appear. And the main function of a merge node is to merge elements together. So let's write our text. I can increase the size of my text, like this. Now I can add a transform node to my text, and this transform node will only affect the text. Now, if I put this transform node after my merge node, it will affect my whole image, like this, see? So that's basically the node workflow and how they interact with each other. And remember, the orientation is left to right, so I can keep stacking as many nodes as I want. Like this, we can create pretty much anything we want. And remember, we have a background and a foreground. The background is represented by this yellow arrow right here, and the foreground is represented by this green arrow right here. So, right now, our text is in the foreground, and our media one is in the background. If I change these connections right here, you'll see that now my media one is in the foreground. So it's covering up the text. So you have to always keep in mind which element you want to be on top of the other element. And I can also change these inputs by clicking on the merge node and hitting Command or Control T. See? The arrows changed. And now my text is back in the foreground. So let's start building our lower third. So we're gonna start out by bringing a multi-merge to our node graph. We're gonna hit Shift spacebar on the keyboard and bring on the multi-merge. like this. And as you can see, the multi-merge has also this white input right here that will multiply every time you stick something to it. So now let's bring a background node and add it to this yellow input. Let's drag our multi-merge to our viewer one. Now let's connect a text node to it like this. Let's write our text. Now we have to limit the area of the background. For that, we're going to use a mask. So let's bring a rectangle mask and connect it to this blue input right here. And now we can manipulate our mask by messing around with our edges. Like this. And like this. I'm going to bring my mask a little bit to the left so I can make some room for my Instagram logo. Like this is fine. Now I'm going to bring the logo. So I'm going to open the media pool and bring my logo to the node graph. And close the media pool now. I'm going to add a transform node to it so I can manipulate it and connect it to the multi-merge. Now I'm going to come to inspector and make it smaller. Like this. Place it right here. Now I'm going to change the color of my background to match one of the colors of the Instagram logo. So I'm going to click on the color, click on this little dropper right here, and pick a color, like this. Hit OK. Another thing I can do is round up the edges a little bit. So I'm going to come to the rectangle mask, come to corner radius, and increase the slider right here, just a little bit, like this is fine. Now I want to add a shadow to my logo, so I'm going to bring a shadow node. Now if I place this shadow node just after my media one, as you can see, the only thing that's going to be affected will be the Instagram logo. If I place it after my text, only the text will be affected. So in order for me to affect the whole thing, I have to place it after the multi-merge. So let me bring the output of the multi-merge and connect it to the input of the shadow, like this. Now I have to bring my shadow to the viewer, and there it is. Let's adjust it, like this. Decrease the alpha a little bit, so it looks a little bit more like a shadow, like this. And I'm also going to change the color to one of the colors of the logo. Let's say this orangish color. Cool. And now what I can do to make some room is select all of these nodes and group them. And I can do that by hitting Command or Control G on the keyboard, like this. And now all of my elements kind of turned into a single element, the lower third. But don't worry, you can still double click the group to open it and adjust each element individually. Now I can add a transform node to it, bring my transform node to the viewer, and now I can manipulate the whole thing. See? Now let's connect it to the media one, like this. Now we can see how all of the elements merge together. One extra thing I can do is add a little camera shake. So shift space bar, camera shake. Place it right after my transform node, decrease the levels. One last touch, we can animate how the lower third gets in and out of the screen. So let's come to where I point to my lower third, like right here. Let's bring it outside of the screen and set a keyframe right here on the center. Now we're going to go ahead like 12 frames and place it right here. So let's manipulate this curve right here, like this, just to give a little roundness to the entrance. Now let's open the spline. And the spline is where we control the smoothness of the curves. So let's click on these three little dots right here and show only selected tool, which will be our transform node. Let's click on it. Now let's click on this button right here, which is the zoom to fit, where we can see both of our keyframes. We're going to select the second keyframe and hit F on the keyboard. Now let's bring our curve a little to the left like this. So it'll look like this. It will start faster and then slow down by the end. See? Now let's make it disappear. Let's do the same thing by the end. Set a keyframe right here. Go 12 frames ahead. Bring it down. Manipulate the curves. Come to the spline. Zoom to fit. Smooth out the end. And bring back the curve. Like this. So let's see how the whole thing looks now. And that's how nodes work in Fusion. So if you like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you want to learn more about DaVinci Resolve, check out this video showing on your screen right now, and I'll see you there.